A lumbar puncture, also known as a spinal tap, is a procedure to collect samples of cerebral spinal fluid from your back. At MD Anderson Cancer Center, your care team will perform the procedure under fluoroscopy or X-ray, using a small amount of radiation. Your care team will send the sample to the lab for testing. The results help with your treatment plan. Treatment may include intrathecal administration of medicine if ordered by your doctor. Intrathecal means that the medicine is given directly into the cerebral spinal fluid. Before the procedure, tell your healthcare team if you have ever had an allergic reaction to betadine or iodine solution, or to a local anesthetic such as lidocaine, are taking blood thinners or anticoagulants, are not able to lie on an X-ray table facing down on your stomach for the procedure, had a recent test that required drinking barium, which is a white, chalky liquid. These tests may include a CT scan, barium swallow test, or GI or small bowel series scan. Are on any isolation precautions, such as contact or respiratory isolation. Your doctor may also order a myelogram and CT scan for you. If you need an iodine contrast injection, your doctor will also order lab tests to check your kidney function. Tell your care team if you are allergic to iodine contrast media. Before the procedure, your doctor will order lab tests, including blood tests and a platelet count, to make sure you do not have any problems with bleeding. If your platelet count is very low, you will have a transfusion before the procedure. You may take your medicines as instructed by your doctor. If you are taking an anticoagulant or blood thinners, such as Coumadin, Eliquis, Lovenox, Plavix, and Xarelto, you will need to temporarily stop taking them. Talk with your doctor about when you should stop taking them. Your doctor may prescribe an anti-anxiety medicine before your procedure to help you relax. You may also receive pain medicine. Do not take them until after you sign the consent form or until a care team member tells you to take them. The procedure takes about 1 hour to complete. Plan to stay an additional hour after the procedure for recovery. Check My Chart for the time and location of your procedure. Your procedure may be canceled or delayed if you do not arrive on time. You will need to have a responsible adult come with you to your procedure because you may not drive yourself home. This person will receive discharge instructions and will need to sign you out before you can leave. A taxi or a rideshare driver does not meet these criteria. If you have an external medical device, you may be asked to remove the device at your procedure visit. Bring additional supplies and necessary medicines as needed. Examples of external medical devices include on-body injectors, continuous glucose monitors, on-body transmitters and monitors, medication pumps, and wound care pumps. When you arrive, check in at the front desk. If this is your first appointment of the day, you will be given an ID bracelet that contains your name and birth date. Make sure the information is correct. A care team member will answer your questions about the procedure. A care team member will ask you to put on a hospital gown and check your vital signs. You will need to empty your bladder before the procedure. Ask a care team member if you need help going to the restroom. Next, a nurse will take you to the fluoroscopy X-ray room, help you onto the table, and position your body. You will lie face down on your stomach. The technologist will take an X-ray of your back and mark the site for the puncture. A care team member will be with you during the procedure and will check to make sure you are comfortable. A betadine solution, or a different antiseptic if you are allergic, is used to clean your back. Lidocaine, a local anesthetic, is given to numb the skin. You may experience mild discomfort when the shot is given. It is very important that you do not move during the procedure. If you experience pain during the procedure, please tell a member of your care team. The technologist will take a series of images to guide the needle to the target area in your spine. The table may be tilted to allow the fluid to flow better. If ordered, chemotherapy medicines may be given directly into your spine through the needle. Your care team will then remove the needle and apply a bandage over the puncture site. After the procedure, you will lie flat on your back for an additional hour. The lights in the room will be dimmed. This is to help you recover and prevent getting a headache. The nurse will be with you to monitor your vital signs. You may eat and drink as usual after the procedure. Follow your doctor's instructions for taking blood-thinning medicines. Be sure to drink fluids after your procedure. Avoid vigorous physical activity. Do not lift anything more than 5 pounds for 24 hours. Headaches can occur after your procedure. Lie completely flat to help decrease the pain. You can also take pain medicine, such as extra strength Tylenol. The results of your tests will be available 24 to 72 hours after the procedure. Your doctor will discuss the results with you at your next appointment. Notify your healthcare team right away if you have any of the following symptoms: drainage, bleeding, redness, or swelling at the puncture site, a fever of 100.4 degrees Fahrenheit, 38 degrees Celsius, or higher. Call your doctor if you have a headache that is not relieved by lying down or taking pain medicine, a headache with neck stiffness and sensitivity to light, persistent or severe back pain, new or worsening pain or discomfort around the puncture site or back. To report your symptoms, call your primary care center Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. After business hours or on weekends or holidays, go to the MD Anderson Acute Cancer Care Center. MD Anderson Acute Cancer Care Center is open 24 hours, 7 days a week. In case of an emergency, call 911 or go to the nearest hospital emergency center. If you have any questions or concerns, call your primary clinic.